Hey everyone, welcome to a new review. Behind me is the new A-Class Sedan. Of course, we're talking about Mercedes-Benz. I'd like to take the new salon I've been working with, Auto Kuća Gašperić. So it's a dealer, Gašperić, in Velika Gorica. It's the first city next to the Croatian airport. Now, we got a car full of tank. We're gonna do in-depth review today. We're gonna take it for a ride. There might be some occasional traffic here. There's some trucks passing by, so we're gonna ignore them. Okay, welcome. Here is the new key of the Mercedes A-Class. So we have lock, unlock button. Let the camera focus on it a little bit. Lock, unlock button, and pump the trunk. It's pretty simple key. Looks nice, feels nice in the hand. It's heavy, definitely not light. And we're going to unlock the car. In Europe, the lock-unlock button doesn't horn, but you can set that up if you want to. Like in the US, it's a standard feature. You can like press if you want to. If someone's, you know, walking next to your car, you think he's suspicious, you can press and the car will horn and the hazards will turn on. So let's unlock this car. You can see the mirrors are folded. If we unlock the car, you can see the LED lights. If I press again, really beautiful. The LED lights turn into daytime running lights and into blinkers or hazard lights. Now let's come closer and see the front look. It's pretty much familiar seen on the hatch. This is the AMG exterior package and interior package. So we have this bottom lip with a chrome, a little more aggressive. We have this side intake that's actually just a blank, it's fake intake on a A35 that will be available in the future. You can get the real intake here. Now, I was away from the car, so it locked itself. I didn't press the lock button, just so you know. Over here, we have the LED, high LED performance lights. You also have a Mercedes-Benz logo in here, in case you missed it. There's gonna be occasional traffic, so we're just gonna ignore it. And in the AMG package, we have this diamond-shaped grille and integrated parking sensors. You can see one here and another, other ones on the side and on the bottom. Over here we have some leaves because they're in their forest. You have a big star that is 3D shaped. Behind this is the radar adaptive or Distronic. Really looks, I mean, it works flawlessly. It's definitely intuitive. I'm gonna show you that later. And works pretty simple. On the top, you have another classical Mercedes-Benz badge. In case you've missed that this is a Mercedes. Haha. Yeah, I know, but I have to joke a little bit. Car looks really nice. Now, there's no traffic. I'm just going to walk on the side so you can see the car. Put it into perspective. Really nice, good aerodynamics. She's gonna walk to the end of the car. So we have also LED lights on the back. If I press the unlock button, you can see the LED lights on the back. They're not sequential. This is nice, kind of unique, but has some sort of Mercedes design and looks. This is the 180D. This is a diesel entry, 116 horsepower diesel engine. On the bottom, we have part of the AMG package, fake exhaust again, but it looks so good. To be honest, you have parking sensors and we have a fake exhaust and this, and this diffuser. So I was personally against hiding the exhaust, but honestly, when I see some old cars and they're dirty pipes, I think this is actually better. And on a real AMG car, you're gonna get real exhaust where you can close and open the vents. So there is logic into latest trends in the auto industry. Over here, we have a LED lights for your license plate, and we have a little camera that pops out when you're going reverse. So we're gonna pop the trunk here. Of course, the car locked itself. Actually, we can just press the trunk button, it'll unlock itself. And let me back up a little bit to the side so you can see a very accessible trunk space, because the lights before were going more inwards. Now they're pushed to the side, so there's more space. Now inside you have, if I'm not mistaken, 420 liters. The hatch version has 50 liters less, that's 370. Now here's my bag just for comparison. There's space on the sides, there's some tether points. Here you can maybe use a net. And there's some over there. If I lower it here, you can see the LED light for the interior. Now if you want to knock down the seats, you can see they're actually knocking down like 20-40-40. And you can actually knock down, actually, yeah. So the middle one, you can knock down from the inside. The two, you have to use this, so you cannot unlock the seat from inside, which is kind of not logical. Don't know why Mercedes did that. Maybe there's some, you can always unlock the middle one if you need to get out of the car, of course, but I don't know. Underneath is this. Well, actually my bag is in the way, so I'll have to take it out. I'm gonna show you. You have a, doesn't this, I don't think this car has an amplifier, to be honest. It has a patching kit and a little space for your first aid, and you know, fire extinguisher kind of things like that. There is like a space here. There's a protection here, so if you're putting cases, suitcases, it doesn't damage your step here. And actually I think it'd be nice if you have a foil here, but it's kind of uplifted. So let's pull this baby, unlock that seat. So we're going to come back in the interior. You have your classic red light and the bottom light to lighten up this area. Closings, there's one point here. The license plate, it's kind of shaky, and it's a metal, so you're gonna hear a little noise when I close it. There's a Mercedes-Benz over here, if you can see that. And let's close. Yeah, as I mentioned, it rattles just a bit, but you know, that's not Mercedes' fault. Just you need to get a better license plate holder, in my opinion. So before we get inside, just to show you, the fuel cap is on your left side of the vehicle. This is a diesel, as mentioned. There's an AdBlue. You have your tire pressure information here inside. And you have, on this model, 18-inch alloy wheels. These are classical 5-star Mercedes alloy wheels. You have a Pirelli tires on it, and you can get 16 up to 18-inch alloy wheels, depending on the package. This car has a chrome bezel, which in the AMG is standard. You could also get the night package. And I'm coming back to the forward just to show you the actual side air exhaust for a better aerodynamics, which is pretty good. So you can see it actually exits over here. You have nice brakes that actually say Mercedes-Benz on them, on the calipers. And that's pretty much it. And on the bottom you get the nice skirt. Also have LED lights. If I use the key, I have to change my hand. You also have LEDs, as you can see here. You can get also the 360 camera system. This car has only a backing camera. So let's open the back seat and show you. Now we have a good soundproof here, pretty decent soundproof. You have double and here two isolations here and on the top. Hey everyone, so just wanted to show you, I kind of washed the car real quick because of filthy of a lot of leaves because it's raining. So to show you the car, so you can see the exterior is wet, inside it's dry because of the rubber. So there's no water. This is dry, this is wet. So the seals are pretty good. You can see wet, dry. So there's no water going in. Some cars have that issue. So it's pretty good. The closing sound is good as well. Not too bad. Now inside you have leather, leatherette. So this is vegan leather as well over here. Really soft and nice, so no animals were hurt. You really don't feel the difference, except there is no special smell. And I kind of support that in a way. So aluminium here, aluminium, actually this is just plastic. And you have plastic buttons, wish that was maybe chromish. This is hard plastic. All robust, plastic cheap but robust, so that's good. And over here we have the seats. We're gonna see the interior space inside. There's some flies going in, and one of this might have stung me later because because it hurts my leg. Anyway, the seats are kind of flat. If you see here, they're not going under the angle down, where it's not that much. At least there is like space here. They are going a little bit inside. Now I'm gonna knock down this seat because I've unlocked it, so it's connected to this seat. So if I pull out, you can see if you have a, you know, if you wanna have a flat bottom, you actually almost do have a flat bottom. It's a little bit angled. And you have a top feeder here if you want to put a child seat, of course. Now, let me close this. Of course, I left the seat belt inside, and now I cannot unlock this for some reason. So over here, if I pull, I can unlock the middle part, as you can see here. I want to close that, and I wanted to show you, but I've locked the seatbelt. There's a little hole you can put the seatbelt in, so if you knock down the seatbelt is not in the way. I actually did that with the other seatbelt over there. So, another thing before I jump in, don't wanted to mention is, yeah, so the holders for child ISOFIX seats are here. I think there maybe might be covers, but they were removed because someone might be using this. So let's sit inside. And space inside, I was sitting on the front. I kind of did go a little bit more up, I mean on the front, because of the review, because if I'm too comfortable, I'm 2 meters tall, 6.6, and there will actually be no space. I mean, there would be lack of space. But if for the average person, there should be more than enough space on the back seat. Now we have a little net here. We have this plastic. I wish maybe it was covered with the leather as well. Have two-tone leather in this AMG package, as you can hear. Let's hear the closing sound. So I'm on the car's angled a little bit, so I have to push a little harder to close. Have that in mind. So not too bad. Closing sound. Now on the back, you can put something here. I really don't know what. I wish there was an AC vent here. I think, as my memory serves me, in other cars I might have seen here turbine vents just like those. So I guess this depends on the package. I think you can order this on the back seat as well. Nice thing is you have a two USB C chargers and 5 volt little space here. And the tunnel is pretty tall, so you can see there might be some legs I can fit here. This is kind of small. There's no armrest in this model. You can order that as well. This is the window. Kind of small, but not bad. Now, the seat is way back, so it is kind of creating a blind spot in your blind spot when you want to turn. On the top, you have a black roof. You have LED lights for reading, which is nice. You have a little hook up there, and it's getting really hot here because the AC is not working. So this is me again, 6.6 or 2 meters tall. I think an average person would be fine if I go like this. I have enough space, so I'm boiling in here. Let's move to the front seat, to the driver's position, and let's check the driver's door as well. Good closing sound, same soundproof as you can see on the doors, in the doors, in the frames. Over here we have a red light and white on the bottom. You don't have that on the rear door. Same robust plastic on the bottom. The speakers, one is here. On this car you have heated seats. You can also get ventilated seats, if I'm not mistaken, as an option. You have nice aluminum here. This is just again plastic, but it's robust, it's grippy, doesn't shake, as you can see. Plastic button. I wish there were maybe aluminium like in C-Class and other models, but I guess this is an entry car, so they kind of left that out. You can lock the rear windows. All windows of course are power windows. You can press here for each mirror and you can adjust them, or you can click to fold. Not sure about the heating mirrors, honestly. And you can unlock or unlock the car in this area. You have a little light here when the car is locked. And here's the space wide here. It's kind of going down, so you cannot really rest your elbow that much. I wish that was actually opposite, but I don't know. That's just my personal preference. You have a Mercedes-Benz aluminium doorstep. Let me just show you, so you missed that. So yeah, you have the speaker on the bottom. And let's cover the seats. So the seats are actually quite good in the corners. You have these bolsters that are holding you. Here they may be a little bit shorter, but the seats are really comfortable as far as I've driven the car. And you have this for your knees. You can like lock it or unlock it. There's actually, you can click here. This is a manual seat, so you can lift this up. So, you know, push up and down, and you can, you know, roll this. And I'm sure there's somewhere maybe a lumbar support, not sure right now. 7-speed automatic, of course. You have sport pedals in the AMG package. And not to forget, you can actually pop the trunk from the driver's position. You have a light switch on the top. You have automatic parking brake, actually electronic. Have your lights. Now, interesting is you can use here, I think, fog lights. Or let me see, like this. So just leave it automatic if you buy the car. But if you're on a parking spot and you want to turn on the lights, just one side towards traffic, you can do this. It's not going to drain your battery. So let me just show you. So you can see the light comes on. This part isn't on. It's when the car is on. So this LED light and the front LED light, while I'm at it outside, let me just show you. The front one's really flickering on the camera, at least the white light. The orange is not. So the other one's shut off, so you can see that. And so if you want to see the performance of the LED lights, you should watch my point of view night video. So make sure to subscribe to this channel to see that. You can leave the lights on, just the position lights. Of course, you're going to get message when it's on. I think this might be a fog light. I'm not quite sure, to be honest, or just, it's just, you know, blank. It's saying this is light, so in case you missed that. You can increase the brightness here for your screen. You can turn on the fog lights, turn them off, and pretty standard, the steering wheel, of course, you can unlock it here, and then goes up and down and up, out towards all directions, so you can adjust yourself, and you have that nice armrest with a touchpad. So let's get in the car and sit to show you the interior functionalities. Now, you have your lights here, and you have Mercedes-Benz. You have your warning here. And let's see here. Okay, so I left the key in my pocket. You can see I actually have enough knee room, but I'm going to just back up a little bit for you guys. There's a handle down there, so I have more space with the camera. Now, if you don't use the car, one screen goes off. Now we're gonna press the start engine. So I get AC working inside. So one more time. So it's really hot. Actually, it's, you can see here, 33 degrees. Now I'm gonna try covering this fast. I apologize about the AC vents. Actually, I'm going to turn them towards down, so these won't blow. Okay, so one thing that really pops in this car and comes into focus with this beautiful turbine vents. You're gonna see them especially in the night point of view, how great it looks. You can customize the lights on the top. You can have dual lights, like two colors. Actually, there are, you can see the bottom one's different. Just really nice ambient to be in. Definitely, that's why I love the A-Class. And you can get that in the entry A-Class, which was before only available in the S-Class. Okay, this is the interior in night. You can see the beautiful ambient lights. Controls are white lights. That's what I wanted to say, beautiful white. AC as well, commands next to touchpad as well. And then you can personalize the colors on the AC vents. Let me just swipe through all of them. You have ocean blue. So you have purple sky, red moon, fire red, down blue, jungle green, glacier blue, color flash, color mix, and I think I showed the, this might be my, actually this one might be my favorite. You can see the vents. If you change the AC, you can set it in the options here. You can set the brightness as well to automatic or full. and you have multicolor and climate, as you can see. Really, really nice. Now on the bottom, let's cover this area first. So you have your temperature here. You can actually see on the screen the temperature. You have your hazards here. You have them in the screens. You have your AC. You can put it on automatic, or I'm gonna actually just lower the temperature a little bit colder. And over here you can press the which area you want the air to blow, for example. And it's kind of good, you know, it's not bad, it clicks really good. Of course the screen is touch, so you can, you know, press here and then you can choose where you want the AC. You can increase the fan speed, of course. You can change the temperature. You can go here, you're gonna go home, and you have, you can lock the air intake only for interior or the exterior. You have rear defrost, front maximum below, and the fan speed, it goes up and down here. So that's the AC. Now the vents are pretty simple. They're open now. If you push it like this, it's closed. Now good thing is this AC has the package where the lights, depending if it's warm or cold, you can show red or blue light here, which is a really nice feature. On the bottom we have this middle bridge with piano plastic, which is personally horrible idea, I think, because there might be a lot of scratches in the future. So I wish maybe this was just silver, but that's just me, that's my personal opinion. You have here a phone wireless charging, so you can put your phone here. Of course you have a phone or tablet USB-C charger. I wish there was maybe an USB-A, in just in case if you don't have the newest phone. There's a 12 volt charger for your adapters. And you have two cup holders. If you press here, these exit, so you can, you know, lock a smaller cup or large cup. This is gonna lock here, and it's pretty it, close it. Now we have a new system here. There is no more wheel, and I like the wheel. I also like the taptic, the touch with the taptic feedback touchpad. It's nice, but sometimes when you're driving, you might, when you're new to the car, press something and it's gonna, you know, distract you on the screen. You still have your parking cameras. Let's press this, see if the camera is going to work. Actually, the car is not on. I'm going to show you that later. You can press car here. It goes into the car, quick settings. You can actually set your favorites here. You can go to phone, radio, media, navigation, and map. In this car, it's not activated. The software wasn't activated because the car isn't sold. It's a test car. And you have your volume up and down. You can press to turn off or press to mute. And on the touchpad, you have a return button, I guess. Excuse me. So you can change the radio stations. And you can press here for home. That's pretty much it. This is just your rest, so you can use that. And of course, over here, almost forgot, you have your dynamic select. So you can select the driving mode. So you have comfort as standard, how economic, have sport and individual. You can actually customize in the settings. If you go here, you can see the drive, steering, ESP. I would advise you to you leave it on. Of course we have an armrest that's actually nice, and in the level of your arm. So you have a deep storage here, it goes a little bit under here as well. You have two USB C chargers. I don't see any SD card slots. Maybe it's integrated in another place, maybe in the glove compartment. And you can see you have a little rubber here. So if I close two of these, you can see in the middle there's room for your cable, so it doesn't get squashed. And that's the whole armrest thing. Now let's cover the interior. This is standard, you see seen in the hatch. And nice on the top leather red, of course. Again, brushed aluminium, really looks nice. And actually this might be plastic, if I'm not mistaken. This is definitely brushed aluminium. Yeah, you can hear the sound. So look here, also some sort of plastic, but it's nice. Doesn't look like it's gonna scratch because the car is used already. Although over here we're gonna have some piano plastic, some fingerprints, or in the future, just don't use your keys, you might scratch something. But the screen is touch operated. Of course you can use the tactic thingy as well. have startup engine standard and auto off, and you have a glove compartment that has an LED light. I think it might have the AC cooling, if I'm not mistaken, maybe not. There is actually decent space here, considering that there are manuals in here. And I wish maybe this was chrome-ish, but you can lock it. Most car manufacturers are losing this feature. You have here bottle holders, and they're covered. There's actually a rubber mat over here inside, and you have LED lights on the bottom and the door handles. And on the top, again, there's a speaker in the A pillar. Black on the top, you have your privacy light. If you open the mirror, you have a light, you can put some documents here. Have a little speaker for the emergency call, SOS. You have Mercedes Me, you can connect with your phone app and get a lot of information from the car. You have your reading lights that are kind of designed as a crystal design. You can turn on the lights and see, really nice. I wish there were LED. They're actually kind of whitish, but I don't know, I'm not sure even if they're LED. They might be, I might be wrong, they may be halogen. Now the mirror is pretty simple. I wish it was maybe bezel-less. This is Mercedes again. This is not creating a huge blind spot, the camera area, so the view in this car is actually not that bad. This is kind of high, but you feel protected. The view is good when I'm driving, personally. You're gonna see that in point of view driving, but if you turn back, this is creating a blind spot over here, and because of the B pillars over here, this is kind of compact hatch, so over here as well a little bit. So you should definitely get the blind spot warning, although you have a blind spot in the mirrors. I'm not sure if you can see the little line, but there are, both mirrors have blind spot in the mirror. Here, how much space I have when I'm on the front. Enough room here, actually not even touching with the hair the rooftop. There's enough room here for a tall person as well. If there's an average person, there's going to be more space on the back seat. And I think I've covered everything, so now we can move to the infotainment. And the only thing that I've missed kind of is the large speaker on the top. So I'm gonna just show you the speakers real quick, because I apologize. So we can show you the rest of the infotainment, which is gonna be a little bit longer. So let's see if I can find a radio station without the ads. Have our presets on the bottom. Let's press this. I think the speakers are pretty good. I think these are standard speakers. I might be wrong, but yeah, the bass is good. Just here, look at it. So, needless to say, the speakers are quite good for the bass speakers. If you get even the upgraded, I'm sure the sound is going to be even way better. You can see the LED lights kind of popping now. If there's a, there's actually sun's moving, so there's shade here. So, before we get into the infotainment, steering wheel is pretty standard. I must say, I love the steering wheel. It feels good in the hands. Definitely refined design, everything is nice. The stitching, you have a perforated leather, excuse me, on the sides. And you have, if you're new to Mercedes, you have now for the touch screens and the just digital screens, you have this haptic feedback. So look at this, I can choose both of these. In this, in the middle, I can move to this bubble and press, and then I move, I can change clock, you know, trip. You can have this either in bubbles on the middle or each bubble, or of course you can always have classic stuff if you move to the side. And then, excuse me, then you can choose the other bubble here. You can press here as well, kind of different information, although the same. Because the maps are not activated, you have just a globe, which really looks nice. The graphics are crispy and it's showing you like the compass. So if I press here, the home button, you have here assistance. You can choose that. And when the car is on, you have more information. So actually, let's turn on the car. You hear the engine purring, diesel. So you can see the cruise distance. And now I'm gonna put this in while I was driving. I'm gonna decrease our speed here. Car is immediately decreasing. Just one press up, you turn it up by 10 kilometers. Really simple, really works very good. There's not, it's not going up by 1 kilometer, it just goes by 10, which is more convenient. We're coming close up to this truck. I'm gonna set a higher distance. The car will reduce its speed. It's keeping distance between us. It's actually decreasing, which is good. If I press the signal, there's no one on the other side. If you're on a cruise control, the car is gonna speed up by itself. You can press here, reset. You can set your cruise, front distance in between the other car, and you can press up or down to increase the speed by 10 kilometers or lower it. It's pretty simple and intuitive to use. I'm going to turn off the car because it's going to turn on the consumption really high, so you're going to think that the consumption is really high. But actually, the AC is working, I don't want to get hot in here. Speed limiter is over here. And again, just if I press home, you have your phone here, you have navigation, trip, radio, media, system display, and service. If I go to system display, you can have this classic, you can have sport. You can see both screens change into a different color. And let me press here again, whoops. You can go to this kind of modern look. Let me just here go to the standard display. This is going to reset both of two, speedometer and odometer. And so just to show you this, it's kind of cool. And I'm just gonna leave it on classic here. So actually the contact is off, so I need to press the brake. Okay, now AC is working, so because I'm sweating here. Again, 33 Celsius degrees outside. So you have the other button for the right screen. So you press home, you can press, if you, I don't know, get into radio, you can press, you can press back, and you can use the little touch here for the menus. So this is interesting. If I'm gonna just change my hand here, if you go down, you can get into these little menus, or you can go even down furthermore, you can have the presets. Like if you're going on a trip, this is going to change. You have to press here to confirm. So you're gonna have your distance. If you go to experience, this is going to change into sport mode. You can get this in the menu, so you're gonna get immediately, like a shortcut to battery voltage, engine output, engine torque, and charging air press. Interesting information. If you wanna just go back, press the back here, quickly here, and you can navigate to, you can actually turn off this display as well if it's distracting. If you don't want to, just press back. Really convenient system once you get used to it. You can also get here efficiency, launch, and standard. I'm gonna just press standard here and get into the standard menu. The screen is really crispy, it's just the graphics is good, and you can use you can set, of course, profiles here. If you have multiple drivers or it's a family car and you're sharing it, you can swipe here. It's really responsive. And comfort, I'm going to show you this colors, multicolor of the ambient lights. You have like presets here that are really nice, especially at night. So you will have to watch this review and my point of view while I'm driving during the night.
Of course, you can set up the brightness and other stuff here really good. While you're driving, you have this information. You can put it to full screen, or you can see the engine, you can see the vehicle status, gas brake when you're using, consumption. Now, the consumption was about 5 liters, maybe less, actually 5.5. Now, I've been pressing the car on the highway a little bit gas, and we're stationary now, so it's going to start rising up. But this is actually pretty good. I think it was 5.3 liters, and now it's kind of going up because I'm stationary and the engine was idling. So, excellent consumption for a 160 horsepower diesel engine. And you have here manuals. You can come back here. You can have the Mercedes apps. I don't have it. You can connect your smartphone. You can have services like Mercedes Me to see, in points of interest. You can find them on your phone and just send them to your Mercedes, which is really nice. Now, when I say Mercedes, it's going to ask, how can I help you? So I'm going to demonstrate this. Hey, Mercedes.
How can I help you?
Set temperature to 19 degrees.
Temperature is 19 degrees.
So, as you can see here, temperature is set. This is the new MBUX that is more adapted to your voice fluidly than the hatch version also, but it gets an air update, so you get that for free. And you really need to know the English fluently, because either it's not going to work if you're bad with English. Just a note. So we have here car settings, and now you have dynamic select. You can customize that. Winter tires speed limit. You can press this depending on your tire, and you can turn on the standby mode. So if you're gonna leave your car stationary, it's not gonna deplete your battery. You can turn on here the acoustic lock, so you can press this. The car is going to honk if you lock it. I'm gonna turn that off. And folding mirrors, automatic door locks. Actually, I'm gonna turn that on. And let me see here. You can always go to the menu. It's kind of actually easier when you're stationary to use the touchscreen feature, but when you're driving, maybe it's better to use the haptic feedback, or just don't use that while you're driving. Just if you're stopping on a traffic light, use it, but try not to use it when you're driving. Of course, here you have speed limit assistance. You can have visual or audio, or just visual. I turned it off because it's flashing. It's kind of annoying. I always drive a little bit 10 kilometers faster, which is here in Croatia tolerated by police. So I actually set up here 10% tolerance, which is a nice feature. Camera parking, maneuvering, so you get warnings, acoustic and camera, active brake assists. You can have early or medium. So it's, I left it on medium. It's gonna also have late assistance. Standard, or it could be sensitive. Zero intention, there's probably a sensor somewhere, I'm not quite sure where, that monitors the driver's face and or similar gestures by steering wheel or sensors or similar. And you can have a 360 view of your car, I guess, here. So you have assistance here. Let me just, so you have your vehicle, you have system, and you have quick access to ESP, lane assist, parking sensors, assistance, where we were, active braking assist, attention assist, active lane keeping assist, and the steering wheel is going to shake to warn you if you're leaving the lane. You can go to vehicle, can configure it, ask when you're starting which profile you want. Lights are ambient here as well. That was a shortcut in the menu. Surrounding light, extinguish, shut down, and you can set the time in 60, 30, I know, or turn it off. And you have your systems here as well. So this is display options, system display. Styles, you can increase the brightness of the display or reduce it while driving at night. You can turn it off like this, or just press again. Day night automatic, or you can change it. Controls, keyboard handwriting, so you can write a letter on the touchpad surface. Touch control sensitivity is on, I guess, medium. You have haptic feedback. You can turn it off. You can have you can turn on like Hey Mercedes. See, it's not reacting. If I press Hey Mercedes. Okay, maybe it's not reacting when I'm in the menu, but usually it always reacts if you just mention Mercedes. You're connected online, and you can see features here. You can set the traffic announcements, audio, phone, and entertainment. You can have here sound, general. And, you know, a lot of information here, traffic announcements. These are off. Phone, active parking assist, voice output volume, and acoustic operation feedback. You can play this just, you know, if you get the new CarPlay on the parking lot, don't play while driving. You're gonna set here Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, of course. You can an NFC, and you have a Wi-Fi inside. Time and date, in Croatia currently. And we have a language here. I left it on English for the review. You have all of these. You can pause here if you want to see. I'm just going to swipe through a lot of languages here. And I think it went somewhere in language. So units, this is kilometers per hour anywhere in Europe. And hold on, let me see this kilometers. Yeah, you can set miles. A license activation for software and software updates, so system backup and pin protection, and you can reset everything. So this is pretty much it about the settings. You can press here always to connect your phone. If I haven't done that, you can press here to turn off the system or the display. I think you can press here. So if you press here, you get the turn off system. And this is pretty much it. So you can go always with the haptic. And has this sound, of course, confirmation. The navigation, as mentioned, is not activated in this car, although you can see it in the middle screen. So this was walkthrough through all the menus you have here. Another maybe shortcut, Mercedes-Me Connect app.
What can I do for you?
Nothing, cancel. You cannot mention the M word, so it reacts. Anyway, when you're here in the menu, like the media, I guess, no, this is still there. I was kind of wondering, I thought it changed it. Maybe no, it's always here, I guess. So anyway, you have multiple shortcuts down here. You have on the screen, and you have here, everything is okay. The engine is not turned on at this moment, so the engine is not broke if you see the light. If you press the brake, now I'm gonna turn on the engine, so you can hear the engine is on. Now, just to show you, these are your wipers. If I actually push it, whoops, no, actually blinker, excuse me. This is the wiper, so this is how it looks. This is, of course, your standard blinkers, and you have your here parking lever. So there's a button here which you press to park. You press down for drive, neutral, and reverse. This is the camera. Sorry if the AC is blowing into the microphone. Actually, crispy graphics. I wish this car had 360 parking camera, which is an optional, but excellent graphics. And you have the beautiful sound and the center array there. And now, if I put to neutral, I know driving gets you alert. And let me just so I'm in drive. The camera is still on, not sure why. I'm gonna press here to have a shortcut left, and let me just see what I wanted to show you. Actually, yeah, the driving select again, individual, excuse me, economical, comfort, sport, and individual. In sport, you can feel that the suspension kind of hardens a bit, and it's more stiff in the corners. And in individual and comfort, it is more comfort. Press for parking, turn off the car. Electronic brake usually turns on automatically. You can see actually over there it's turned on, so you really don't have to use this. And it's pretty much it. The graphics are great. Absolutely everything about this car is pretty impressive, what you get in the entry Mercedes car. Let's exit here. And actually, I wanted to pump the trunk and show you the engine bay area. So, Mercedes has this. Now you can see it. So it's one pull only, not twice on this model, I think. Actually, on the Mercedes, it's only once. And you have to find the latch, it's in the middle. So you push it to the left. Now we have a one damper, which is really nice. And this is the engine. This is the diesel. So entry diesel with 116 horsepower. I think this might be like something like 1.6 liter. And this, I know what you're gonna say, this is the Renault engine. So Mercedes is working with Renault, and Renault has really good engines. They're really reliable. They can go cover a lot of mileages or kilometers. So even in the C-Class, you get the Renault engine. They're really good. There's nothing bad to say about them. Now, today, you get a Mercedes-Benz engine only in the real AMG cars. So if you don't know that, you know it now. Again, Renault engines are really good. This is a Mercedes car. And I don't think Mercedes would risk giving you something that's that they don't think is quality made, so that they don't think it's reliable. So this is something, you know, you should know. This is your engine oil, pretty simple. If you're new to the car, this is your coolant, and you have your washer fluid here, your brakes, I mean your batteries here, your oil for the brakes is down there, and you know, I think that's it. This is good because there's a lot of area. It's kind of big to cover, I mean, to easier service of the car. And let's just close the trunk, just leave it to drop. Of course, I have to mention this car is one of the best when it comes to aerodynamics. There's really, really, really low drag on this car. So it's a really good, efficient in the aerodynamics. Washers are pretty, I mean, the wipers are pretty simple. I think there are washers integrated over here. Of course, you have your camera on the top and a rain sensor, as mentioned. And I think there was supposed to be a serial number. Actually, I saw it under the hood. I wanted to mention that, kind of slipped my mind what I was talking. And I think we're gonna end the video here with the beautiful Mercedes A-Class. I want to hear your opinions. Tell me in the comments below what you think about the sedan version. This is like a compact sedan, smaller version. If you spec this car, you're easily reaching into the price of C-Class. So, you know, you've been warned. People like to click stuff on the configurator and have packages. So, you know, you should calculate what you want. The entry price here in Croatia is actually 31,000 euros, and the hatch is like 30,000, if I'm not mistaken. This model is a little bit more expensive. I know the Kuna figure, I'm not sure in the euros, but anyway, this is the entry model. You can get the, let me just check here. So you can get the 116 horsepower, this is the entry model. You can get a 150 horsepower and the 190 horsepower diesel engines. Although those are not available for the sedan yet in Croatia, they're only available for the hatch. Petrol engines, you can get the 163 horsepower version, the 190 and 224 horsepower, which is the strongest engine. And I saw on the hatch there's like 90, no, there's actually 105 horsepower version. So might get available in the future on this is the hatch, so might be get available on the sedan version. Of course, you can get the 4MATIC all four-wheel drive. This car is just a front-wheel drive. And I think we've covered everything. I hope I didn't miss anything for you guys. Tell me in the comments, what do you think?
how do you like the car, and make sure to subscribe to the channel to see me driving, because I'm gonna put the camera on my head, my GoPro, 4K of course, just like this video, and I'm gonna head out, drive 15 minutes without talking, and then going to do later tonight a night drive where I'm gonna sum up all of my experiences for you, what I think about the handling, the performance and driving part, and you can see the car lighten up in the night. Well, big thanks once again to Mercedes Gasparic House, the dealer, for lending me the car and for wanting to work with me. So if you want to see more Mercedes-Benz reviews in the future, we're going to get every model from them. I mean, I'm going to test every new model for you when it comes first here in Croatia. And so if you don't want to miss that, make sure to hit that subscribe button, click the bell to get notifications, turn them on, and of course leave the comment below what you think and like this video. Every like really helps, and every interaction with the video, like comment, helps me a lot so I can create more new car reviews. Thank you for watching. Stay safe on the road always, and be responsible. Gonna see you in the next video. Bye.